Hi, I'm Mark Needham with StarTree. In this video, we're going to learn about upserts in Apache Pinot. The upserts feature is useful when records need to be modified or updated. Pinot supports two types of upserts. We can have full and we can have partial. Partial means that only some of the fields in a record need to be updated. But in this video, we're going to focus on full upserts, which is where we want to update all the fields except for the primary key or primary keys. So we're going to start with a data generator that simulates the prices of stocks on the NASDAQ index. And it generates a new price every 0.1 seconds. So we're going to have a lot of prices coming through. And you can see we get the ticker, the last trade price, the bid price, the ask price, and then the trade value. All of these are completely made up. We're now going to use a tool called Red Panda Keeper. To create a topic, so we're going to create a topic called stocks, and we're going to give it five partitions. Once we've done that, we're going to stream that the data from the data generator into Apache Kafka. So we'll use the JQ tool to make sure we get a key and then the payload. Now, one thing to keep in mind here is that the partition key that we're using, so here it's ticker, that needs to be the same as when we're configuring things on the Pinot side. So just keep in mind that we're using ticker there. Now we're gonna have a look at our Pinot schema. So if we just quickly look at that. So you can see the schema name is stocks, and notice under primary key columns, it's ticker. So it needs to be the same as what we had in the stream. Otherwise you'll end up with duplicate values. And then if we sort of go down, you can see we specify the other different values. We've got the trade price, the bid price, the ask price, the trade value, and then we've got the timestamp. Now let's have a look at our table config. So again, it's called stocks. It's a real-time table, so expect we're going to be streaming data in. One thing to notice is that the consumer type needs to be low level when we are creating an upserts table, otherwise it's not going to work. If we scroll down a little bit more and we look under upsert config, notice that we've got full, and so that means that all fields except for our primary key are going to be replaced by new values when they come in. And then what we need to do is we also need to specify under routing, instance selector type is strict replica group to ensure that all segments of the same partition are processed by the same server. And so that's to ensure data consistency. Now that we've reviewed that, let's add the table. So we'll pass in the schema file, the table config file, and where our controller host lives. We'll give that a few seconds. And now we're ready to go and have a look at that in the Pinot UI. So we're going to write a query just to get some records from stock. So you can see they're sort of coming in. So we've got these are the latest entries for each of the stocks that we've got. Let's now zoom in on one of them. So we'll have a look at Microsoft. So we'll say, hey, I want to select from the stock, get me the ticker where it's MSFT, and show me it in reverse chronological order, although that actually doesn't make any difference. And if we run the query a few times, you can see that the price is being updated and the volume and the timestamp of the ticker always stays the same. And you notice that the query is always returning the latest record for Microsoft. Now the other records that we've got, so like we've been capturing every 0.1 second, remember? The other records are still there. It's the reason we can't see them is because Pinot has an in-memory dictionary that keeps track of the latest record for the primary key. So remember the primary key is ticker. So we've got just the latest value per for each ticker. And then when we write a query, the query engine sort of checks the dictionary, consults the dictionary and says, hey, what is the record that I need to return? And then it just returns that record. Now we can disable that dictionary when we're querying by passing in the option skip upsert equals true. And so if we do that, then we can see all the changes to the Microsoft stock price over time, like from the different transactions that were done. And so that's the end of this video in which we've learned about full upserts in Apache Pinot. Give it a try and let us know how you get on, and I'll see you in the next video.